Hazards are all around. Cars, ladders, banana peels. A staircase can be a hazard. The risk is possible injury, or worse. Hazards are anything that can cause harm. Risk is the potential for a hazard to cause harm. A seismic hazard is the probability of ground shaking due to earthquakes and other effects of earthquakes, including ground rupture, landslides, tsunamis, and soil liquefaction. Seismic risk is the likelihood that humans might sustain injuries and fatalities, plus economic losses due to the hazard. Risk and the perception of risk are not always aligned. A seismic hazard map assesses the possibility of future ground shaking at a location based on the past history of nearby earthquakes and ground shaking, plus what we know about faults in the area from geologic, geodetic, and seismological information. The hazard also depends on how the ground responds to shaking, which depends on the subsurface rock layers. In an open field, someone experiencing strong shaking would just fall down. Hence, most seismic risk comes from the possible collapse of buildings due to shaking. Let's look at two examples. A person in a high seismic hazard zone in a well-engineered high-rise has low seismic risk. A weak structure built in a low seismic hazard zone may have high seismic risk from even light shaking. Risk assessment takes into account the hazards, population density, man-made structures, weak building materials, and more. Again, a seismic hazard is the probability that earthquake shaking of a certain intensity will occur in a given geographic area within a given window of time. From that, risks can be assessed and included in mitigation efforts.